Did I ever tell you what the definition of insanity is? Insanity is doing the exact same fucking thing over and over again, expecting shit to change. That is crazy.
Orange Lemonade political organization builds war chest topping $100 million Orange Lemonade. Political organization entered July with nearly $102 million in cash reserves, an unprecedented war chest at this stage in the election cycle for a former president. According to new figures, so who's he going to fight? Orange Lemonade fundraising hall speaks to his continued ability to raise money from small dollar donors online, as he trumpets baseless claims that election fraud led to his loss last year. Sore losers always cry. Orange Lemonade team said 3.2 million contributions flowed into the former president's political committees during the first 6 months of the year. More than he deserves. In a statement, Orange Lemonade once again complained of a stolen election and cited the donations as a sign that millions of Americans share my outrage and want me to continue to fight for the truth. While I lie more often than anyone else and cause riots and bad touch ladies. Orange Lemonade fundraising apparatus includes two political action committees, Save America, a leadership PAC, and the Make America Great Again PAC, along with a separate joint fundraising committee. Most of Orange Lemonade's cash reserves are stockpiled in his Save America leadership PAC, with $90 million remaining in its accounts as of June 30. New filings show giving the Republican a large sum to unleash as his party seeks to seize control of the House and Senate in next year's midterm elections. Orange Lemonade also has hinted at seeking the White House again in 2024. Oh goodness, this man can't take a hint. Well, if he does come back, we will all in for some more funny content and egotistical ramblings. On that note, new numbers show he remains the GOP's dominant fundraising figure, despite losing the election and access to social media platforms, proof why censorship doesn't really work. In announcing his fundraising totals, which were first reported by Politico on Saturday, Orange Lemonade's team said his committees had raised nearly $82 million in the first 6 months of the year, but that total also included funds collected in 2020 that were transferred into his account this year. The rich get richer. Orange Lemonade's spokesman Jason Miller on Sunday said the transfers were included because they amounted to all new revenues to Save America for this period. Save America. Yeah, the prices for everything is going up and CEOs make 512 times more than their employees, but yeah, Save America. Save America is the former president's primary fundraising and public relations vehicle, and he uses it to issue statements endorsing his favored candidates and denouncing those he opposes. But the PAC had not contributed to any congressional candidates during the first 6 months of the year, according to its filings with the Federal Election Commission. Miller told CNN that checks began going out to endorsed candidates in July, after the period covered by the new filings. Leadership PACs such as Save America have a cap on donations, but federal rules impose few restrictions on how their contributions can be spent. And during the first 6 months of the year, the PAC spent about $68,000 for lodging and meals at the Orange Lemonade Hotel Collection. According to records, that's some expensive food. Then Orange Lemonade has also endorsed a super PAC, Make America Great Again Action. The Super PAC's filing Saturday night shows it took in a little more than $5 million as of June 30. Individual donors include Don Ahern, a Nevada businessman who contributed $1 million. All right, we all know that was Dr. Evil, former Georgia Senator Kelly Loeffler at $250,000, and MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell at $100,000. Lindell has been on a mission to advance claims that widespread fraud contributed to Orange Lemonade's defeat. Of course, an elephant's fly. The Super PAC recently has begun spending to boost Orange Lemonade favored candidates, pumping $100,000 into an unsuccessful attempt in July to help elect Texas Republican Susan Wright in a special runoff for a U.S. House seat. Ha, epic fail, another fail for a lifetime loser. Wright lost to fellow Republican Jake Elzey. Another GOP primary on Tuesday, this time for a U.S. House seat from Ohio, will offer the latest test of Orange Lemonade's ability to sway voters. Oh, he can sway certain people, you the stupid ones, people who think injecting bleach can cure disease. Make America Great Again Action has spent more than $400,000 so far to promote Orange Lemonade's choice. Coal lobbyist Mike Carey. In the Columbus area special election. If you want to make America great again, how about decrease the prices for everything? These absurd prices are killing me ridiculous. Well, that's it for maybe I'm rambling. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Peace out, y'all. Orange is a bad color.